liftoff.
Welcome to a very special episode of the Scartlight Magazine vodcast from here in the grounds of the historic Royal Observatory Greenwich. We're here for the Astronomy Photographer of the Year Awards Night 2011. Over the course of the next few minutes, we're going to reveal the winners of the competition and also speak to some of the top astro images from around the world.
The first category to be announced at this year's awards was Earth and Space. The Young Astronomy Photographer of the Year Award went to Jathin Premjith for his image of the totally eclipsed moon.
We had nearly 800 entries this year. It's people from all around the world who've entered the competition.
So this is the winner of this year's Young Astronomy Photographer of the Year category. It's an absolutely amazing picture of a moon in the lunar eclipse just moving aside from a background star. The timing involved is absolutely staggering.
It's astonishing that this was taken by a 15-year-old. The beautiful colours on the moon come from the sunrises and sunsets on the Earth, the sunlight shining through Earth's atmosphere.
The Astronomy Photographer of the Year 2011 competition is organised by the Royal Observatory Greenwich, London, in association with Sky at Night magazine. Running in its third time, the entries received were almost double than the previous year. There were photographs in the categories of Earth and Space, Our Solar System, Deep Space, and Young Astronomy Photographer of the Year. There were two prizes for Best Newcomer and People in Space. The panel of judges selected the 24 prize winners whose works were displayed in the Royal Observatory Exhibition Hall.
We're standing next to the winner of the Young Photography category, and it is Jathin's photograph of the moon in eclipse.
I think it was just really striking, the colours really let out, you know, compared to seeing lots of black and white or quite sort of subtle colours, then something this strong, I think, instantly grabs the eye.
Events, isn't it? It's the eclipse itself and the beautiful colours, but also the occultation. Which is even rarer, I guess. So it's great that this is in the young category, but actually I think it would have stood up really well in any of the adult categories. I look forward to seeing what Jathin does next year.
Absolutely.
The Royal Observatory Greenwich in London is best known as the location of the prime meridian and the home of the Greenwich Mean Time, or GMT, making it the official starting point for each new day and year. It is situated on a hill in Greenwich Park, overlooking the River Thames. Having a longitude of 0 degrees, 0 minutes, 0 seconds, every place on the Earth is measured in terms of its distance, east or west, from this line. It houses a magnificent 120-seat digital laser planetarium and is also home to the 28-inch Grubb Refracting Telescope of 1893, the largest of its kind in the United Kingdom.
Day rather than at night.
So, and they would be used for studying things like eclipses. They were sent all around the world, so the photos that you took of the eclipses in previous years, kind of similar idea to that. And so that's memorialised as the weather vane of this building.
You know, in 2009 I got third, the highly commended, 2010 also, 2011 I was like, you know, just before they declared the results, I was checking on Twitter, and so I was searching for a long time, I didn't find anything, then suddenly it came, Jathin Premjith won the first, so I was like, excited and too.
Well, we're glad that you could make it to the observatory today, and congratulations on taking such an amazing picture, it's really beautiful, so I think we're all...
And you've got form over 3 years as
yes.
well, which is very impressive.
Forward to seeing what you submit this year.
Yeah, I have a plan to go to Norway and to take the aurora lights.
Aurora pictures, right. So you've done the moon, now the aurora is your target. Excellent.
I don't think we've had any auroras in the young category so far. So.
No, we haven't. Yeah. You could be the first young aurora photo. Okay. So.
We're going on January.
That would be wonderful. Yeah. And dark.
Yes, very dark. Very dark, very cold. Take your warm coat.
Jathin traveled to Selsey, located 60 miles from London, to meet Damien Peach, who is the 2011 Astronomy Photographer of the Year.
For the telescope.
Yeah.
Various different settings. You've got different tracking rates. You've got different rates at which you can move it with the handset. That just keeps the object that you're looking at in the field of view all the time.
I have a 4-inch and an 8-inch.
Right.
Started with a 4-inch.
Yeah. I mean, more than just being a photographer, I'm also interested in them scientifically. We actually discovered that the Great Red Spot rotation period is much, much faster now. So it's spinning much faster than it was back when Voyager visited Jupiter in 1970s. When you really understand something and have an interest in the object itself, it makes it infinitely.
Thank you very much for giving me your winning photo.
Yes, you're very welcome.
2009 it was a deep space object.
Mm.
2010 it was Earth and space. I think now the first time planet is getting first.
Yeah, that's definitely good to say, yeah, I think.
Hello, I'm Pete Lawrence and I'm here with Jathin, who had a fantastic photograph in the Astrophotographer of the Year, and you won your category, didn't you? And it was a superb photograph of a lunar eclipse with an occultation about to happen. There was a star just off the edge of it. I do remember it quite distinctly. But to get that colour with a lunar eclipse is really quite clever. You did a fantastic job with that, and I think you should be very happy and very proud of the photograph you've taken. Now I'm just worried because you're going to get better than me, so...
At the residence of Sir Patrick in Selsey, there are two observatories. The larger one, housing a large wooden 15-inch Newtonian reflector telescope, and the smaller one containing a 5-inch Cook refractor telescope. He's also a self-taught xylophone and piano player and an accomplished composer. He is an amateur astronomer who attained prominent status in astronomy as a writer, a researcher, a radio commentator, and a television presenter. He presented Jathin with one of his famous books, Legends of the Stars, with his signature.
What I did, I began by reading books. I think of the summit, went outside, and led my way around the sky.
Here are some of the achievements of Jathin Premjith. He received awards twice earlier in the Young Astronomy Photographer of the Year competitions of 2009 and 2010 in the highly commended position. Jathin is also into wildlife and Formula One photography, and his work has been published in many international magazines and journals.